I'm here with Henry. He's the owner of Bagel Express. He's been in business for many, many years. And this is Henry here. We're gonna have a conversation on how he started the business. And there's the question for you. How did you start the bagels and what got you into it?
I was bouncing around. I finished school, had a degree in political science, couldn't figure out what I wanted to do. And had a mutual friend that had had a friend as well that was starting in the bagel business and was not happy where he was, and I was looking for a business. I wasn't keen about going to law school, I wasn't sure what I wanted to do. And at that time, so I had, you know, made some money building houses and done some spec building with some friends of mine.
Yeah.
And I was looking for an outlet. At the time, I was gonna be, basically build it out, be the silent partner. He was gonna run it, and we'd go from there and see how it worked, and go, you know, hopefully build the business and go from there. I wasn't sure
whether
I still might go to law school, what was gonna happen. And what happened is, like everything else, partnerships are very, very difficult. After
sure.
a couple of years, it was obvious that it was gonna be me or him. It just couldn't work like that. I ended up building it myself with some help of some contractors, friends of mine. We, you know, put it all together, built it out. It was going okay. And as we were building it, though, Hurricane Andrew hit.
So I remember
it changed,
that one.
It was a big dynamic, huge change. Miami changed like night and day.
For sure.
Probably, maybe, different situation right now, but it was that drastic. Our initial plan was just to have a bagel shop, bagels, cream cheese, sliced Nova, sliced lox, sliced deli meats. I had brought Boar's Head to Miami, one of the few people in Miami that had Boar's Head way before Publix had it.
Wow.
It's a New York product, basically.
Oh, really?
Just moved in isolated locations down here.
Wow.
Specialty shops, and we brought it in here. I knew from experience of traveling and also experience it was a very high quality product.
Right.
And we brought that in. It was going to be a sandwich shop and just sliced Nova. Bagels, cream cheese, made homemade bagels. And we hand rolled our bagels for the first 6 years.
Yeah, I read that. I read that.
Well, I have two shoulder replacements now, thanks to that. But I decided to make a different kind of bagel.
I was going to ask
steam
that.
Steam bagel. Other places, the steam bagel. The old style boiling and baking a bagel. It's a real bagel product. It's a chewy, dense product. A lot more flavor. It's a real like old New York style bagel. And as I said, it's a lot cheaper to do.
You say New York, and you've mentioned it a few times. Did you bring that from New York? You traveled
Miami.
A lot, but tell me.
My partner learned from an old gentleman from New York years and years and years ago.
Okay.
And I kind of backed off of him with that and learned on the fly, basically.
Got it.
From there, you know. But it was the way you make them. No matter how you make them, boiling and baking creates a much different product. They just take him the new style, the way Einstein makes them, they take the bagels, same type of machine, but they put them on sheet pans and they put them in an entire rack. And the entire rack goes inside the oven and it spins around for about 20 minutes and it comes out all at once.
Wow.
The way we make them is we put two dozen in a boiling pot of water, pull them out, line them out on things called bagel boards, which are aluminum boards with burlap on them, lay them out, put the seeds on, put the boards inside the oven. It's a rotating bread oven. It goes around two times. You have to flip them upside down to cook it. And 20 minutes later, you're pulling them out in a big, like it's like a pizza.
Like a pizza. Okay.
And dropping them in the basket. So it's a lot more labor intensive, a lot more costly, but it makes a lot better product.
Cool.
So we stayed with that all along.
That's awesome.
I've always been a guy, but give them what they want, but charge them for it. I don't cut on materials. I use the best materials. I don't cut corners. I use a thing called liquid malt versus brown sugar.
Okay.
I use the high quality flour. I do not use a lower end flour.
So what do you, when you say, what do you do for the firefighters or first
responders? We give them a discount. We buy them food. Sometimes we send stuff to the stations on occasion. In hurricanes, we send leftover products we make and send to the shelters in previous hurricanes.
So if a firefighter comes in, he'll get a discount.
We have a specified price for firefighters.
Cool. That's awesome.
For first responders, military, right. And stuff for help out a little bit.
That's awesome.
Try to do what we can.
And the schools, what do you do with the schools?
We have a contract with the schools. It's bid out every few years. And it's a fundraising event. What we do is we deliver bagels to the schools every day. Individual departments who we deal with sell them to the children and the kids. Children, all high schools. And they use the profit from that to fund their programs. Unfortunately, it's money they actually need for their programs, not extra money. It's money they need for their equipment, for their field trips, for their trips to state tournaments.
Of course.
Maybe athletic departments and activities directors who we deal with. And we've dealt with them for about I'm thinking probably somewhere between 17 and 20 years. We've dealt with them. So I think it's either our third or fourth contract now.
That's amazing. So, I mean, I see people coming in. I know you're doing well. Tell me how exactly has the virus affected you and what you've done to, you know, well, try to help.
Dade County School spent $303,000 last year on bagels.
Wow.
This year, I'm not sure what they've spent, but it cut off March 16th. So we're down about, the last 2 months, we're down about $25,000 each month just from school revenue.
Wow.
I would say out of $300,000, at least two-thirds of that revenue comes to our business here. We deliver to 22 high schools every day.
Wow.
Every morning, it's about 200 dozen bagels a day. And it all fills in the blanks, a combination of small retail that. We also supply a couple of restaurants as well on a wholesale basis, small amounts. We really just actually drive right by there on our school route, so we're able to facilitate it for both us and them, and it works out very well. We did a little bit of work with the school board. It was nice enough to give us to help them when they were feeding the free breakfast for the kids in the summertime.
Okay.
About a month, they gave us some work, helped us revenue-wise, and helped us keep staff on board. And we bagged the bagels individually, which is quite a task because it was between 4,000 and 5,000 bagels bagged every single day.
Wow.
To bring them out to these schools.
Did you have to bring more staff to help you?
I had more staff. I had a lot of summer help when it was going
good
on. You know, people that were students, college students, that obviously had nothing going on at all. It worked out well. We were able to get it done. It worked very efficiently. And both sides were really happy the way it worked out. They helped us out and helped them out as well.
What advice or what would you give me as an entrepreneur advice on how to make it, you know, last year, you know?
Food business is very, very tough.
But there's something about you that's, you know, different than anybody else. So, and you've stayed open that long, so you're doing something right. So what is that secret sauce?
You don't have to be so much ahead of the game, but you have to keep up with your demographics, with your economic changes, with your, you know, your wants and needs of your customers, your customer base, and trying to try a few new things. Don't overextend yourself, but work with an open mind. You know, I'm not always right, but I'm never wrong. You know, so I mean, it's just like the joy of working for yourself. You know, I mean,
right.
You bought yourself a job.
Yeah, of course. So how do you do it every day? I mean, because
I didn't come here, I'd be bored. This is my social life too. I
good.
Talk with my customers.
Good.
Most of our customer base you can have a conversation with, mostly in English, some in Spanish.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's just it's not an unpleasant experience. The unpleasant is things that happen in any business or life where, you know, no hot water heater breaks in your house, something happens, you know, something goes down, the flat tire, the deliveries, supply chain's really tough right now.
Okay.
Because of the situation. So you have to adapt, you have to be flexible, and you have to hustle, you have to be working. It's not for faint of heart, it's not for lazy people, that's for sure.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people that I talk to, they think that they're gonna open up a business and be like successful all of a sudden, then they're gonna actually have to work more hours as an entrepreneur than, you know,
absolutely,
you work,
absolutely.
You know, you're nine to five.
I've done well here, I've done okay. I'm not, you know, I have no complaints about that. Right now it's tough, we're getting by, we're making it, we're not going anywhere. As an entrepreneur, if you get in business, from my side, use the best products you can. Give people what they want. If you have to charge them for it, that's fine. Pay your staff well, take care of your staff, they'll take care of you. And, you know, that's, it just works, it all comes together, you know?
All right.
I mean, I don't want to talk about salaries here, but we pay better than most places, I think.
That's awesome.
Our type of stuff, you know, people don't leave. They, with kids have been with other people been here, they come, they leave, they come back.
That's
they don't
awesome.
Like me till they leave, they realize I'm not as bad as they thought I was. And, you know, we try and work with people, like I said.
Awesome.
We try and make it, you know, we feed them, you know, we don't charge them for the food here. We feed them, we try and work with them, we work with their school schedules. If they need days off for personal reasons, we try and work with that as best we can.
Awesome.
And just move forward. Like you said, if it gets to be in a really nasty environment, you know, I would have walked away a long time ago. Awesome.
Well, Henry, thank you so much for your time. I'm going to post, I know you're not really big on your social medias, but I'm going to put them all out there. I'm gonna put all the information from, you know, for your shop, phone numbers and all that on the channel. And you know, thank you so much for your time. It was an awesome story.
I appreciate the time.
You know,
so
yeah.
Much.
No, thank
appreciate
you for real. It was a pleasure.
Come on,
it was a pleasure.
Have a bagel. You see what I'm talking
awesome.
About?
Awesome. We'll record
the best bagels.